this gland is your gland for $100, for $100. Maybe it is dollars, I don't know.
And the question is, which of the following endocrine diagnoses, this is a softball, which of the following endocrine diagnoses is associated with a prominent forehead, a heavy brow ridge, a broad nose, accentuated nasolabial folds, a large tongue, and large hands and feet? Is it acromegaly? Is it Cushing's disease? Hypopituitarism? Hypothyroidism? Or prolactinoma?
Discussion on this one.
Yeah, they were going to call it Bundrick's disease, but they changed it to acromegaly. And let's see why. Now, extra credit points. Who's the person on your left? Who's the person on your right? I mean, this is a very cultured community here. I heard about the culture of Seattle, and I'm glad to know that pro wrestling is part of the arts and sciences of Seattle. But old Andre the Giant, like many of these people who had unrecognized acromegaly, had to make a living of some sort using their odd physical nature. Okay, next one, John.
This gland is your gland for $200.
Which of the following is the ideal maximum excursion of postprandial glucose in patients with diabetes? So that means after a meal, what's the acceptable level it can go up after a meal? 40 to 60, 60 to 80, 80 to 100, or 100 to 120?